I'm really happy for this fight. It's happened. Really happy to show the world. Even everything is saying that about me, I'm doing wrong, I don't do good. I'm used slapping, too aggressive. Okay, for me too, to show myself I got something, this young kid is right here to show all over the world I got something to prove on June 2nd. I'm really happy for that.
Now you're in condition, you stay in shape. Tarver had to get in shape, but his advantage is going to say, he's going to say it's experience. His advantage is going to say that he's a better technical boxer. How do you intend to combat that?
Well, if you see the good punch, if you good punch landing on him, all the memory, all the thinking, all the speed, all the stuff he tried to do, sneaking, he can't get it. But I'm not going to give him a chance to do all the stuff he want to do. This is the fight. This is not about running. This is not about holding. Stay, nigga, let's fight. We got to fight. Yeah, we got to fight. And I believe, by the name of God, first, I will knock him down before fifth round. He don't go nowhere. He thought it's still the same. What you thought, it's not the same no more. Everything he think he do back there is gone. So he fighting one time in a year. I didn't want to bring it back to me. I fight like five times, six times in a year. So it matter how he have experience. It matter how I'm strong, being there, being in shape every day. So why kind of people like that want to scare me? Or he's the one scared, he's not in shape, he's not, that's your problem. If you're not in shape, well, who cares? On June 2nd, you got to show me what you got. I'm going to show you what I got. That's all.
Now, you're an emotional guy. You're clearly high energy about this. But one thing that he would say is that your emotions in the ring can become a disadvantage. How are you going to keep those emotions in check, being that you're so angry to some extent?
Yeah. You know, this game, this is a game. Like I said earlier, if you go on YouTube, on Boxing Record, he have a guy, I don't know the guy, he have a little beard here, he have a big head. The guy was there, the guy was saying bad about me, like he know me. He don't know who I am. The guy was saying bad, Latif, Coyote, you fight Tony Ottawa, he do like this, he go like this, he fight so, he don't know me. He don't know what I eat, he don't know what time I sleep, but he's talking like he know me. That's the guy that he set up to get to my head. So right now, what I'm saying right now, I'm not saying to get to his head. I'm saying what I'm going to do to him, and I'm going to do to him, I'm going to give him a good fight. Everything he's thinking, I'm going to go there, aggressive, ghost. If I deal with you with the crazy, mad, talk, angry, that's outside. When you get to the ring in the fight, I can't use that to you. You get to the place, we have to use experience to experience. You know, exchanging the power to power. That's one you belong to. So what I'm saying right now, I'm saying the way I'm feeling, the way he's talking about all the stuff he's talking, the suspect, about what I do. And what makes me mad about this stuff now, he was saying on Showbox, I don't have experience enough, I don't have nothing to prove. And he coming for a sparring partner for Danny Green. He called my manager to call me for a sparring partner. I said, hey, no, I don't do a sparring partner for him. If you want to fight, I want to fight him. My manager smiled. He said, I'm not going to fight you. I said, why? Because he know you. I called Gary Shaw. I said, Gary, I want to fight this man. He said the same thing. All right. And Tony Ottawa said, I'm not ready for a championship. Maybe a couple, two more fights or three, but I'm not ready yet. You see, God changed the plan. God changed the plan because I was waiting for somebody else, Grandma John in the Panama, for WBA. But God Almighty, he changed the word. He changed the word he say about me that I'm not ready. He changed it to him. Okay, the world title championship is gonna be you.
Now you take criticism not very well, but your trainer is widely accepted as the best trainer on the planet right now. What does he say to you about the skills that you need to work on? What is it that you feel you do need to improve on to fight, compete at this level?
Okay, anything, the only one thing I think I need to work on it, and I'm working on it, and I show you on sparring, I show you in the gym to calm down, patient, let it come. And I'll do working on it, and it come. So for him talking shit, I don't know how to cut the ring off, I don't know how to do this. I've been cutting ring off all the time I've been fighting on Showbox. He's just the last two fights, I fight this guy, I'm forgetting his name. I fight the guy, he was running. If he showed the fight again back, my right leg, it was so tight. I was drawing the leg. I can't move it to cut the ring off. So I don't know. You know, everybody have a bad day in the fight. You can't just have it. But I thank God I win the fight. By the close to the fight, seven or eight rounds, my body's warm, loose, relaxed. I do better. So I got 1 point. I win the fight. I'm really happy for that. So that is the only thing they're standing for. They're waiting on. Okay, I don't know how to cut the ring off. You want to run? Okay, let's run. Keep running. The ring is not far. So we'll see on June 2nd.
I feel like you want to win the fight. You expect to knock him out, but that might not even satisfy. Do you really want to hurt this guy? Is it personal?
So bad. I want to hurt him so bad. I want to put in a handicap. He says it's not a handicap. I want to put in a handicap, really, and I will destroy it.
Radio Raheem with Keode Latif. He's ready to handicap Antonio Tarr.